Hi everyone, I'm Peggy Kay, and today I'm going to show you how to live stream to YouTube using just your Chromebook or any computer that has an up-to-date web browser, webcam, and internet connection. You have two options. You can quickly and easily go online using the camera attached to your Chromebook or computer using the camera go live option, or you can set up a Hangout on Air event, which lets you invite guests to participate with you in the live stream, webinar style. To start a live stream using your webcam or other camera attached to your computer, sign into YouTube and click the Create button at the top of the page. From the menu that appears, select Go Live. All you need to do is add a title for your live stream and select whether the broadcast will be public or unlisted. Under More Options, you can set which camera and microphone attached to your computer you're using for the broadcast. In the Advanced Settings, you can disable live chat and turn on age restrictions or indicate whether your live broadcast will include a paid promotion. To get started, click Next. YouTube will take a picture of you to use as a thumbnail. But don't worry, if you don't like it, you can take a new picture or upload a custom thumbnail of your own. Click Share to share a link to your live stream to social media, copy the link, or get the embed code to embed the live stream video on your own website. When you have everything set up the way you like it and you're ready to start broadcasting, click the Go Live button. In the live stream window, you'll be able to see how many people are watching the live stream, how many gave it a thumbs up. You'll be able to get the video link to share. And you'll be able to participate in and moderate the live chat. Be sure to say hi to your fans. When your stream is over, click End Stream. YouTube will show you some basic statistics about your live stream, and then you can return to the completed live stream event list. If you want to set up your live stream in advance or invite other people to participate with you in the live stream, you can set up a Hangout on Air. To do that, go to your live streaming events page and click New Live Event. Make sure you set it up as a quick event rather than a custom event. Once the event is created, you can't change that setting. You can then choose whether your live stream will be public, private, or unlisted, add a title, set a time for the event, and add a description and tags. There are also advanced settings which let you enable or disable the live chat, set promotional and distribution options, and set whether the archive automatically becomes unlisted once the Hangout on Air broadcast is over. Click the Create Event button, and that will add the Hangout on Air event to your upcoming events list. To start your broadcast, return to the upcoming live events page, find your event, and click the Start Hangout on Air button to launch the Hangout video call window. In the Hangout on Air window, you'll see the option to chat, which is for discussion between participants on camera in the Hangout on Air, and this will not be visible to viewers of the live broadcast. You can choose to screen share any window on your computer, or you can use one of the Hangout on Air apps, such as Hangout Toolbox or Cameraman. Click the Invite People button to get a link to share with other participants in the Hangout on Air. They can click the link to join you in the Hangout window. You can also adjust settings for the amount of bandwidth you're using and the camera and microphone that you want to use. You can also get the link to the video or the embed code to embed the video on your website. However, there is no option to share to social media directly from inside the Hangout window. Click the Start Broadcast button to start your live stream. If you want to participate in or moderate the live chat, you'll have to open your video watch page. When your live stream is over, click Stop Broadcast. You can find your completed Hangout on Air live stream, along with your other completed live streams, on the Live Events Completed Live Stream list. From there, you can immediately edit your live stream's title, description, tags, and privacy settings. Once your live stream archive has processed, you can then add a new custom thumbnail, do basic editing, and add cards and an end screen. Your live stream archive can be up to 8 hours long, so the only limit is your imagination. Well, that and the YouTube community guidelines. If you found this video helpful, be sure to subscribe for more creator tips and tutorials.